Greetings and welcome to this session on refrigeration and air conditioning. Today we will be looking at duct design. Now, as you have studied the previous systems like vapor compression, vapor absorption, then aircraft air cooling system, like this same duct design is also a very big topic. Okay, there is designing of duct, testing of duct, manufacturing of duct, and so on. So there are many things involved here. There are standards also. First of all, we will be starting with what is duct, why it is required in HVAC. Then what are the different types of duct, classification of ducting system based on velocity and pressure. One more parameter is there based on which we will classify the ducting system. Then different configurations of duct, how you can arrange the ducting system. Then what are the general design requirements? Okay, so general guidelines for designing duct. Then different methods of duct design. Also, we will be looking at a software which is called MacWay Duct Sizer, using which you can design duct. Okay, that is the actual way by which duct is designed. Basically, if you see the overall duct design, there are four methods, but in those four methods we have certain tools. Like first tool is charts and tables that we will get from ASHRAE handbook. Then second is ductulator. Okay, it is a very interesting tool. You can Google it out. It is a cardboard type device in which you have certain places where you can rotate the things. Okay, and you can match the pressures and other parameters, and you can design duct directly from that tool. Okay, very interesting tool. You will find that it is available on Amazon as well. Then after that, one more method is using software, which is MacWay Duct Sizer. Okay, now theoretically the duct is designed, it is something a bit different. Okay, and actual practice, whatever duct is designed, that is a bit different. We are going to study both the methods, theoretical as well as actual way by which duct is designed by the consultants. Now, what happens if you see mostly Middle East countries, okay, majorly Arab countries, they have lot of demand of HVAC engineers. Okay, and mostly you will find that HVAC engineers, mostly from India, they will find job in Arab countries. Okay, and there mostly the knowledge of piping engineering, then central air conditioning, then duct design, this is very helpful. Okay, so we'll start with the duct design. Now, what are ducts? Okay, ducts are passages that convey the conditioned air from air handling unit, AHU means air handling unit, to air distribution points and carry the return air from the room back to AHU for reconditioning and recirculation. Meaning there will be an AHU. Okay, in AHU you have fresh air duct, which is also called ventilation air. Okay, it mixes with recirculating air. Okay, so here you can see return air that is mixed, conditioned, and again sent back to the space where air conditioning is required. Okay, same thing is written here. Ducts are air passages that convey the conditioned air from AHU to air distribution points and carry the return air from room back to AHU for reconditioning and recirculation. Now, this air distribution points, these are called air terminal units. Okay, we will be looking at the different types of air terminal units as well in brief. Then why is ducting needed? Okay, suppose you have a large room like this and you have four ACs. Here a kitchen is there, and at this location you have cafeteria, and here one room is there. So the issue is you cannot use the exhaust fan, okay, on one of the windows. Suppose this wall doesn't have any window. Okay, you have window here, but here also you have some room, here also you have some room. So if you are using exhaust fan, basically you are trying to exhaust the hot air from kitchen to some other room, okay, which is undesirable in this case. Also, if you are using four ACs like this, person who is sitting right in the direction of airflow, he will feel cool, whereas the person who is sitting here, he will feel hot. So here you can see at the center we have hot patch. Okay, so basically what we require is ducting over here. So because of ducting, air will be distributed uniformly inside the room. Okay, same in case of kitchen, instead of directly exhausting the air to cafeteria or other room, we can use a ducting. Okay, so here you can see now we have air handling unit will be there and a blower or a fan is there. Okay, this is the main duct, okay, which is called trunk. And here you can see these are branches. Okay, these are branches and these are air terminal units, ATU. So there are different type of ATU, like there could be a resistor, there could be a grill, there could be a diffuser, okay, and so on. So there could be different types of air terminal units. So we have a fan or blower, then a trunk, then branches, and then finally air terminal units. Similarly, there will be air terminal units for return air. Okay, so this is suppose supply air. So similarly, there will be some diffusers which are for return air. So again, that return air, it will come from the room back to the AHU. Now here also you can see I have provided a fan in kitchen and there is a duct which is actually exhausting the exhaust hot air from the kitchen to the atmosphere. So this is the reason why ducting is required. Now we will see classification of duct system based on velocity, pressure and type of air. So what is the difference between velocity and pressure classification? First we will see that before going into actual classification. So duct velocity classification influences noise, vibration, friction losses and fan power. So if you consider a duct, okay, a duct of particular cross section, and if velocity is more, then what will happen? Noise will be developed, friction will be developed. Okay, so that is why velocity classification, it influences noise, vibration, friction losses and fan power. Whereas if you see the pressure classification, it influences the duct strength, deflection and air leakage. Okay, what is meaning of duct strength? It should not burst. If the pressure is high, the duct should not burst. That is meaning of this duct strength. Okay, so duct pressure classification influences the duct strength, deflection and air leakage. And the third type of classification is type of air. So we will see these classifications now. Now these classifications are standard. Okay, these are given in the standard data books like carrier handbook, and this is majorly given in chapter 2 of carrier handbook. Okay, so I'll show you a carrier handbook so that you can understand how it looks like. Okay, so if you go to page 19 of this chapter 2, which is air distribution carrier handbook, here you will see the classification. Okay, here we have velocity classification. Now they are classifying according to the supply air and return air. Okay, so their classification is bit different, but our classification is bit different. Okay, and then based on pressure also they have classified. So like this, if you consider the carrier handbook, okay, first one is cooling load. Okay, I'll show you this part as well. So if you consider actual system, okay, this is the cooling load estimation sheet. Okay, now this sheet is very important. Usually in industries, okay, or consultants, they use this sheet to decide what is the cooling load for a particular room. Okay, now this is a manual method. You can take the printout of this sheet and you can do this manually, or there is a E20 form that is called Excel E20 form. I'll show you that form as well. I'll just give you an idea so that you are aware. If you are trying to join HVAC industry, you will be aware that these things exist. Okay, so here you can see this is an Excel sheet of the same, okay, that career chart which you saw here, this chart. Okay, same chart, it is converted into Excel form. Okay, so I'll show you that Excel. This is the Excel. And to fill in, here you can see how the heat load is calculated, basically cooling load. Here you can see different glasses are given. Okay, north, northeast, east, southeast. And wherever we have a window and a glass, according to that, we have to consider the load. Here we have wall. Okay, similarly different infiltration, outside air is there, ventilation, infiltration is there, people, lighting, equipments, other things are also considered here. And based on this, we calculate the CFM. Okay, cubic feet per minute. What is the value of flow rate of air required? Okay, so this data from here, using this E20 form, this forms the basis of duct design calculation. Okay, now to calculate this, we have certain other things as well. Okay, I'll show you the data which is taken here. Okay, you will find like this, these are the different datas. We have ambient design data. Okay, like different cities are involved here. And for different cities, we have different dry bulb temperature. Okay, different parameters are there. Similarly, you can consider ventilation data. Okay, from this standard, then one more thing I'll show you. This is appliance data. Okay, if you are selecting a particular appliance, what should be the load in that case? Okay, so like this, in ASHRAE handbook, there are different datas available. So using this data and E20 Excel sheet, we basically find what is the CFM. Okay, what is CFM? Volume flow rate of air, cubic feet per minute. Okay, and this forms the basis of the duct designing. Okay, so we'll come back to the classification of duct system. Okay, now ducts are based on velocity. They are classified as low velocity, medium velocity, high velocity. Okay, if you consider low velocity, velocity is up to 2000 fpm or 10 meter per second. These are called low velocity system. Then velocity between 2000 to 2500 or 10 to 13 meter per second. It is called medium velocity systems. In SI units, what is meaning of SI unit? International system of units. We have unit of velocity as meter per second. But if you consider IP units, which is used by United States, it is also called imperial units. There velocity is written in FPM. So that is why here both are given, because basically if you see ASHRAE, it is American society, right? So majorly they will be following imperial units, IP units. So I have given here both IP as well as SI units. Okay, so here usually high velocity systems, they are from 2500 FPM to 4000 FPM. Now next is classification of duct system based on pressure. We have low pressure system, medium pressure system, and high pressure system. Now here when we are discussing this, we are considering static pressure. What is static pressure? We will see afterwards. So based on static pressure, this classification has been made. So when fan static pressure is less than 3 inch of water column, okay, this will be in gauge. So that is, and duct velocity, air velocity inside the duct is less than 1500 FPM, that is 7.5 meter per second, we consider it as low pressure system. Then in medium pressure system, when fan static pressure is in range of 3 to 6 inch of water column, okay, and duct velocity in general, it is less than 2500 FPM, that is less than 12.5 meter per second. And third, high pressure system, when fan static pressure, it is in range of 6 to 10. Okay, somewhere you will find this as 6 to 12 as well. Okay, what is that? We will see. So majorly when we say about fan static pressure, it will be in range of 6 to 10 inch of water column and duct velocity less than 4000 fpm, which is less than 20 meter per second. These systems are called high pressure systems. Now this we have talked about static pressure. What about total pressure? So based on total pressure, this classification you will find in Carrier Handbook chapter 2 page 19. Okay, which I have shown you. Okay, in that you will find low pressure system where pressure is 3/3/4. Okay, 3/4 of an inch of water column in gauge. And here we basically, when we consider these divisions of pressure ranges, we consider class 1, class 2 and class 3 fans. Okay, so this is called class 1 fan. Then medium pressure 3/3/4 inch to 6/3/4 inch of water column, that is gauge. This is called class 2 fan. And when you consider high pressure, it is 6/3/4 to 12/4 inch of water column in gauge. This is called class 3 fan. Okay, here whatever pressures are given, this is related to total pressure. Whereas if you consider the top one, which is shown in black color, it is static pressure. Okay, so that is why here you will see some deviation is there. Here you can see this is 3 inch of water column, whereas here you can see it is 3/3/4 inch of water column. Okay, why? Because this is static pressure and this is total pressure. Next, classification of duct system based on type of air. Okay, so we have different types of air. One is supply air, one is return air duct, then fresh air duct. Fresh air duct is also called ventilation air, and exhaust air duct. Next, we will see what are the different shapes of duct. Okay, we have round duct, where we have small pressure drop and it is cost effective. Then round duct with spiral construction. Okay, if you see the chimneys, okay, industry ka jo chimney rehta hai, those chimneys, if they are circular chimneys na, you will find that there are some spiral structures on the chimney. Okay, why this spiral structure is provided on the duct, round duct, or on the chimney, this you should find out. Then next we have a flat oval duct, and next we have rectangular duct or square duct. Now flat oval duct, it combines the advantages of round duct and rectangular duct. Okay, now I'll give you the answer of this. What is this basically? If you consider this duct, there is vortex generation. If you consider air is moving over this duct, what will happen? There will be vortex generation behind this duct. Okay, and because of that, what happens is there will be vibration in this duct, because there will be a low pressure zone created here. This is called vortex shedding phenomena. And because of that, this duct can vibrate. Okay, and the structure can collapse. So in order to prevent this, this spiral construction has been provided. Okay, this is very interesting topic. Further, you can read about the vortex shedding part from Google. Next, we will see different duct materials. So we have galvanized iron sheet, which is widely used, okay, in comfort and commercial application. What is this galvanized iron sheet? It is zinc coating done to the iron sheet to prevent rusting. Next, we have aluminium sheet metal. It is light in weight, resistance to moisture. Okay, it doesn't corrode easy. Okay, so there is resistance to corrosion. And this type of duct made up of aluminium, it is used in commercial application for aesthetic requirement. Then we have carbon steel. Then we have, this is about the metallic part. Okay, then we have non-metallic duct as well. Okay, like fiberglass duct, which is used for low velocity application where thermal and acoustic treatment is required. Then cement asbestos duct, where the exhausting material is corrosive. Okay, in that case, we can use cement asbestos duct. Then wooden duct are also available, where moisture content of air is not large and fabric duct. Now, stainless steel ducts are also there. It depends on industrial application, okay, for process requirement. So according to the process, we can also have stainless steel duct, then we can have PVC duct. Okay, now this we will see some details of this fabric duct. Okay, here you can see a fabric duct has been shown. If you visit the Thakur Mall, okay, central jo Thakur Mall hai in Dahisar, there you will find this, you will be able to see this fabric duct. Okay, they have actually not covered this inside the fall ceiling. Okay, fabric duct, it is there. Fall ceiling is not there. Okay, in Thakur, if you visit the Thakur Mall, there directly fabric duct you can see on the top side if you visit. Next, these are the different types of fabric duct: permeable fire retardant duct, non-permeable fire retardant duct, antimicrobial fire retardant duct, and anti-static fire retardant duct. Then there are multiple shapes available in fabric duct, like round, half round, rectangular. And to maintain the shape of the duct, shape retention rings (SSR) maintain the shape when there is no air flow within the duct. So what will happen if you see the duct? If there is no air flow inside the duct, what will happen? This duct, it will not be inflated like this, right? Okay, so the shape might change. So that is why shape retention rings are used. And this fabric duct, they are available in multiple colors like white, red, yellow, blue, gray, etc. Next, we will see components of ducting system. So here you can see we have air handler. This is the return air. This is supply air plenum. And here you can see this part, this is called trunk. Whereas on the trunk, you can see here small holes are there and some attachment is used. Okay, that is called takeoff. From takeoff, we have multiple branches. Okay, so what is meaning of plenum? Plenum, it is made up of sheet metal, and plenum is the connection between the air handler and the trunk. Then what is the main trunk? Here you can see this is the main trunk. Main trunk or trunks are the part of duct system that all the air from the system is going to travel before we take off the main plenum to the diffusers or grill. So there will be diffusers or grill at the branches, end of the branches. So here you will find takeoff is there. Then there will be branch, and then there will be diffuser or grill, which is air terminal unit. Then here you can see takeoff is there. What is takeoff? It is part of the system where we take the air off the trunk to supply air to the living area of the house. Then ATU, air terminal units, like grill, diffuser or resistor. Diffuser is an outlet device discharging supply air in direction radially to the axis of entry. So basically, there are different types of diffuser as well. Okay, there is, it's not like we have only one type of diffuser. So this diffuser supply the air in different direction. Now what is resistor? Resistor is grill equipped with damper control valve. Okay, so you can change the direction of air in resistor. Whereas in grill, you will have a fixed type of vane. Okay, so we have grill, then we have diffuser, and then we have resistor. Okay, now here this diagram has been introduced over here to show you the sign conventions which are used. If you consider here the supply diffusers, okay, there you can understand the sign convention. Here you have a box with two diagonals. Okay, so two diagonals indicate supply. Whereas if you consider here, return grills are shown, and this return grill has only one diagonal. So one diagonal is what? It is return. So in supply, we have two diagonals, and in return, we have one diagonal. Now, basically, as you have studied AutoCAD, okay, what is AutoCAD? It is used for drafting, right? So same way, there will be HVAC drafting, and there will be different symbols being used in HVAC drafting. So these are the two symbols which I have told you for supply and return. Now we will see different duct configurations. Okay, first configuration is reducing trunk. Here you can see the trunk, it is being reduced. Then next one is perimeter loop system, then radial system, spider duct system, extended plenum system. Okay, now we will see this extended plenum system, reducing trunk system. Here what happens basically, here you can see this is a plenum and this is a trunk and we have branches. Okay, and this here you can see the dimension is same in extended plenum system. Next, if you consider the spider duct system, okay, here you can see the central part, this is the supply plenum, and from here we have, these are the flexible diameter ducts which are connected to remote mixing boxes. So here you can see these are mixing boxes, and from here we have branch ducts or runouts which are connected to air terminal units. So this is called spider duct system. Next we have radial system. Okay, in radial system we don't have main supply trunk. Okay, directly from the supply plenums we have branches or runouts. Air is supplied to outlet individually. Then if you consider perimeter loop system, here we have centrally we have the supply plenum, central supply plenum is there, and through the feeder the air is supplied to the perimeter loop, and from there air is distributed. So these are some different type of duct configurations. Next, now this is very important concept, aspect ratio for rectangular ducts. So if you consider round duct, there we don't consider aspect ratio. If we have rectangular duct or square duct, there we consider aspect ratio. What is aspect ratio? Aspect ratio is ratio of long side to short side. For example, we will see example of this. Suppose we have airflow of 4000 CFM. What is this CFM? Q dot, volume flow rate of air, considering 1000 FPM. Okay, 1000, this is velocity. Okay, 1000 feet per minute. So here we will do simple mathematics. What is that? Q dot, volume flow rate, is equal to area into velocity. This you have studied in fluid mechanics. We have CFM, which is Q dot. We have FPM, which is velocity. So we can find what is area. Okay, so area comes out to be 4 square feet. Okay, so now I'll show you two examples. One duct, it is, we finally need what? 4 square feet of duct. Okay, so here we have 2 into 2 square feet. Okay, which is 4 square feet. And here we have the width is 4 feet and height is 1 feet. Okay, so this will be again 4 into 1 feet. Cross sectional area, it will be same, right? What will be that? It will be 4 square feet. So in both the examples, we have same cross sectional area, that is 4 square feet. But what about perimeter? What is perimeter? Perimeter is, this is 2 feet, this is 2 feet. Okay, so if you consider this is A, this is B. So A plus B into 2, right? So 2 plus 2, 4 into 2. Perimeter is 8 feet. If you consider the second case, here we have this width is 4 feet and height is 1 feet. So 4 plus 1, 5 into 2, 10 feet. So perimeter is 10 feet. What about surface area? Surface area, if you consider this duct is having 1 meter, this duct is having 1 feet of run. For example, okay, similarly here also we will consider this duct is having 1 feet of run. Okay, in this case what will happen, what will be the surface area? Surface area will be perimeter into length. Okay, so here perimeter is 8, इंटू 1 feet रन. सो वॉट विल बी द सर्फेस एरिया? 8 square feet. बट इफ यू कंसिडर 4 into 1 feet ऑफ डक्ट, ओके, हियर ऑल्सो वी हैव 1 feet ऑफ रन, डक्ट रन, एंड द पेरीमीटर इज 10 feet. फॉर 1 feet रन सर्फेस एरिया इज हाउ मच? 10 square feet. सो हियर यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड, फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन गेट इम्पॉर्टेंट कंक्लूजन दैट इन फर्स्ट केस एरिया इज वॉट? 4 square feet. इन सेकेंड केस एरिया इज वॉट? 4 square feet. विच एरिया? क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया. बट इफ यू कंसिडर द एस्पेक्ट रेशियो, वॉट इज द एस्पेक्ट रेशियो हियर? वी हैव 2 and 2. सो रेशियो ऑफ लॉन्ग साइड टू शॉर्ट साइड इट विल बी 2 by 2, विच इज 1. सो फॉर स्क्वेयर डक्ट वी हैव एस्पेक्ट रेशियो 1. इफ यू कंसिडर रेक्टेंगुलर डक्ट, रेशियो ऑफ लॉन्गर साइड टू shorter side, what is that? 4 upon 1, it will be 4. Okay, so when aspect ratio is 4, here you can see surface area is increasing. What is meaning of this? For same cross section we are using more material of duct in case of rectangular duct. So square duct is what? Preferable. Okay, same thing is written here in the theory. Higher aspect ratio, here you can see aspect ratio in second case it is 4. So higher aspect ratio is there in second case, which is rectangular duct. If you consider square duct, aspect ratio is 1. So higher aspect ratio means more metal surface is required for same cross sectional area that we have proved here, that increases both initial and operating cost. Why? Because here you can see if material is more, meaning friction will be more, so operating cost will also be more. Okay, initial cost is more. Why? Because here we have more surface area, meaning we have more material, so initial cost is more. And operating cost is more. Why? Because since we have more surface area, meaning we have more friction. Okay, so that is why the duct should be as nearly square as possible. Next we will see comparison between round duct, square duct and rectangular duct. Again we will have same parameters. Okay, we will consider cross section area of all the three ducts as 1 square feet. So here you can see cross sectional area is 1 square feet for round duct, square duct also 1 square feet, and rectangular duct also 1 square feet. Now if you consider, if you do the reverse calculation, okay, what will be the diameter, what is the cross sectional area of a circle? It will be π/4d². From there you can reverse calculate the diameter. Okay, so diameter for 1 square feet if you consider it is 13.54 inch. So when you consider diameter of 13.54 inch we get 1 square feet area in case of round duct. For square duct it will be 12 into 12, so you will get 1 square feet. Why 12 into 12 inch? Because 12 inch is equal to 1 feet. So this is basically you are multiplying 1 feet into 1 feet. Okay, and then if you consider rectangular duct, 24 inch into 6 inch, you will get 1 square feet. So if you calculate the perimeter, for perimeter of round duct, so here considering the perimeter of round duct which is pi d, you will get perimeter as 42.53 inch. In square duct you will get perimeter as 48 inch and in rectangular duct you will get the perimeter as 60 inch. Now if you consider again 1 feet run of the duct, you can find what is the surface area. What is surface area? It is perimeter into length. Okay, so here you will find that it is having the least surface area, and as compared to round duct, square duct, it has 12.86% more surface area. Okay, if you consider rectangular duct, it has 41% more surface area as compared to round duct. So here you can see, if you consider round duct, square duct and rectangular duct, which one is better? Round duct. Even though we say round duct is better, if you find majority of the locations you will find rectangular duct. Okay, nowadays you will find round duct as well. Okay, but why rectangular ducts are used then. Okay, I'll give you a simple example. Okay, here we have a ceiling. Okay, and here we have a floor. This is a room. Now, on the top side, we have false ceiling. So, if you consider the height of this false ceiling, this is very limited. Okay, so basically, HVAC engineer, he has to work with this height of the false ceiling. So, one dimension of the duct, it is fixed by what? It is fixed by the height of this. Okay, height, the distance between the ceiling and the false ceiling. So, this height is fixed. So, that is why in many places you cannot consider round duct. You cannot consider square duct as well. Why? Because if you consider square duct, this it will not fit over here because we have restriction of height. So, that is why majority of the places you will find that rectangular duct is used, because one height is fixed and we have to maintain some aspect ratio in such a way that the initial cost and the running cost should not be more. Okay, and as per the SMACNA standard, what is SMACNA, we will see later, aspect ratio should be less than 4. Okay, so we should maintain aspect ratio less than 4 in our final design of duct. So that is why even though round duct is preferable, but we don't have choice and sometimes we have to use rectangular duct. Even we cannot go for square duct in many places. It depends on what? It depends on the distance between the ceiling and the false ceiling. Okay, if suppose the project is high class, like if you are considering a palace is there. There you have lot of space between the ceiling and the false ceiling. There you can use square duct, there you can use round duct. Okay, you will not have any problem. But when we have restricted space, there we don't have choice and we have to use rectangular duct. Now we will see what are the advantages of round duct and disadvantages of round duct. Advantages, we have less friction. We have already seen why, because material used is less. So if material is less, surface area is less and there will be less friction. The pieces can be joined easily together. So we have, suppose multiple ducts are there, they can be joined easily. Better for medium to high pressure system, there is less noise pollution and cost is less for initial installation. Disadvantages, they take up more space. Not efficient for low pressure system. Difficult to connect fan coil to main duct. Like this, there will be for each duct. Okay, for square duct, for oval duct, for rectangular duct, there will be advantage and disadvantage. Okay, I am not going to discuss each duct in detail, but I have made you aware of the basic things. Furthermore, you can read from internet, okay, related to what are the advantages and disadvantages of oval duct. Okay, they are very straightforward. Okay, now some of the advantages and disadvantages here, if you see, they are based on experience. Okay, actual field side experience, based on that they have written here advantages and disadvantages. Now this derivation is very important. What is this derivation? We will see. This derivation is mostly asked in your university paper. Okay. Equivalent diameter of a circular duct for a rectangular duct. Meaning, we can convert the rectangular duct into equivalent circular duct with the help of equation which we derive over here. Or you can do the reverse thing. If you have diameter of circular duct, from there we can go and calculate diameter of rectangular duct. If we fix one dimension, that is if we are fixing the height based on the space constraint, we can fix the other dimension. Okay, so this we will see when we are looking at the design part. You will be understanding this part better. Okay, when we are looking at the design, how you can convert the equivalent circular diameter into a rectangular dimension for a duct. Okay, now in order to find the equivalent diameter of a circular duct for a rectangular duct, for same pressure loss per unit length. This is very important. What is written here? Same pressure loss per unit length. We shall consider following two cases. Okay, one is when quantity of air passing through rectangular duct and circular duct is same. Okay, so I'll show you the cross section here. Suppose this is rectangular duct and suppose this is circular duct. Okay, now what is Q? Quantity of air passing through rectangular and circular duct. So from this duct, what will pass? Q, quantity of air. Then longer side of rectangular duct, it is denoted by A, and shorter side is denoted by B. So what will be aspect ratio? It will be A by B. Then D is what? Equivalent diameter. So capital D will be equivalent diameter of circular duct. AR is cross sectional area of circular duct. What will be that? A into B. Next, weighted perimeter of rectangular duct, PR. What is this? It will be 2 in bracket A plus B. Okay, then AC is what? Cross section area of equivalent circular duct. It will be pi by 4 D square. Then PC, it is weighted perimeter of equivalent circular duct, which is given by pi D. And rho A is mass density of air. So based on these notations, we will be developing equation of equivalent diameter of circular duct for a rectangular duct. First case is quantity of air passing through both rectangular and circular duct is same. So if you consider equation of Q dot, volume flow rate, or here they have used notation Q, it is equal to area into velocity. So velocity will be equal to what? It will be Q upon area. So for circular duct, velocity of air passing through circular duct, it will be Q upon cross sectional area of circular duct, and velocity of air passing through rectangular duct, it will be Q upon cross section of rectangular duct. Okay, now we have studied head loss due to friction. What is that equation? FL V square upon 2G into M. Okay, here you are writing D. Okay, but instead of D, I am writing M. What is M? Hydraulic mean depth. Okay, now if you multiply this equation, this is what? Head loss due to friction. How to convert head into pressure? You have studied this equation in fluid mechanics. What is that? Pressure is equal to rho gh. Now we have hf value. You have to multiply this hf value by rho g to get pf. So same equation is written here. Here you can see this equation. Okay, so we have to multiply this hf by rho g to get what? Pf. So if you multiply by rho g, what will happen? This g will get cancelled. So you will get fl v square into rho a, density of air, upon 2m. Now what is velocity square? It will be q upon a square. Pf is what? Basically, head loss due to friction. We are considering it in pressure value. Head loss hf, what is the unit of this? Suppose meter. What will be the unit of Pf? It will be Newton per meter square. Okay, when we multiply rho g. Now, hydraulic mean depth, it is given by cross-sectional area of duct upon weighted perimeter of duct. Now, pressure loss due to friction, it is, we will calculate for circular duct and rectangular duct. Okay, so Pf for circular duct, it will be this value. Okay, here only what we have to write, in case of M, we are replacing it by cross-sectional area upon weighted perimeter. It will be for circular. That is why C is written here. Subscript is C. Okay, so when you simplify this, you will get FL rho A q square. Here we have q square because here we have velocity square. So velocity square means q square upon a square upon 2, and in bracket we will have perimeter upon cross sectional area cube. Okay, same thing I have written using suffix for circular duct and rectangular duct. So we have equation 1 and 2. Now since pressure loss is same, okay, so this we can equate. We have same friction factor, length, density and quantity of air. Here we have initially written quantity of air passing through both the duct is same. So that is why Q is also same. So only terms remaining on left hand side and right hand side, it will be what? Perimeter and cross sectional area. So here you can get PC upon AC cube equal to PR upon AR cube. What is perimeter of circular duct? It will be pi d upon cross sectional area. It is pi by 4 d square the whole cube equal to perimeter of rectangular duct 2 in bracket a plus b bracket complete divided by cross sectional area of rectangular duct AB and whole raised to cube because we have AR cube. So if you simplify this, okay, here if you simplify this, you will get the final equation like this. D is equal to this term. This term is there. And when you consider this 32 divided by pi square, the whole raised to 1 by 5, you will get 1.265. So D is equal to, this is what is D? Diameter of equivalent circular duct, it is equal to 1.265 in bracket a cube b cube upon a plus b bracket complete raised to 1 by 5. So what is this equation? This equation can be used when quantity of air passing through rectangular and circular duct is same. Next we will see when velocity of air passing through rectangular and circular duct is same. What is the equation? Okay, here you can see this is the final equation which we get. Okay, so we'll see how to derive this equation now. Again, we will go back to the previous slide. Okay, here we have the equation PF is equal to FL rho A V square upon 2M. We will consider this equation, and in this equation, we are only substituting value of M, which is cross section area upon weighted perimeter. Okay, we will keep velocity as it is. Why? Because we are considering same velocity. So velocity will get cancelled. Okay, so here I have written PF for circular duct, PF for rectangular duct. Okay, so now if you consider equation 4 and 5 for same pressure loss, same velocity. So same pressure loss means we can equate 4 and 5. For same velocity of air, we can cancel V square on both the sides. Friction factor, we can cancel F. Density, we can cancel rho A on both the sides. And length, we can cancel L on both the sides. We can write perimeter of circular duct upon cross-sectional area of circular duct is equal to perimeter of rectangular duct upon cross-sectional area of rectangular duct. So if you substitute the values here of perimeter and cross-sectional area, you will get equivalent diameter of circular duct is equal to 2 into AB upon A plus B. Okay, again this can be simplified as 2A upon A by B plus 1. Okay, and A by B is what? Aspect ratio. So these two equations and the derivation of this, it is important. Remember this equation and remember this equation. This part you have to remember. This will be required while solving numericals. Now this is called friction chart for circular duct. We will be using this friction chart for solving numericals. Now understand this friction chart. On y axis we have air flow in meter cube per second. X axis we have friction loss in millimeter of water per meter of duct. Okay, then this is Q, which is meter cube per second, and if you consider these inclines, these are velocities in meter per second, and if you consider this one, this is diameter of circular duct. So using this, we can calculate diameter of circular duct. And once we get, so what will be the question? What will be the numerical? We will see that. Question is given, okay, certain conditions are given. Based on that, using the friction value, flow rate or velocity, we can find what is the diameter of circular duct. Now, aspect ratio or one length of the rectangular duct can be fixed, and using either equation 6 or equation 3 based on the given condition, whether quantity is same through both the ducts or velocity is same, we can find the length of rectangular duct, that is A. Okay, if we are fixing B like that. So in this way we can solve the numerical. We will see the numerical on this in next lecture. Now we have different types of pressures. Okay, we have static pressure, we have velocity pressure, and we have total pressure. So we will see what is static pressure. Measure of static energy of air flowing is called what? Static pressure. Now in order to understand this static pressure, you can take example of balloon. Okay, air which fills a balloon is a good example of static pressure. Static pressure, it exerts the pressure equally in all direction. Okay, so basically this you can call it as bursting pressure. Okay, duct it is trying to burst. That is given by which pressure? Static pressure, PS. Now, what is this system actually? We will see that. This, here we have a fan, here we have duct. Okay, here there is a room, and if you consider room, here static pressure will be zero gauge. Why? Because we consider atmospheric pressure as zero gauge pressure. Absolute pressure, if you consider, it is 1.01325 bar. But if you consider gauge pressure, it is zero. Okay, so if you consider room, static pressure in gauge, that will be zero. Okay, now when we are using fan at this location, the static pressure will be more. Okay, so same thing is written here. Because the static pressure is above atmospheric pressure at a fan outlet, this is the fan outlet, air will flow from the fan through any connecting ductwork. So air will flow in this direction until it reaches atmospheric pressure at the discharge. So here we will have zero gauge pressure. So this is about static pressure. Next we will see velocity pressure. What is velocity pressure? Measure of kinetic energy of air flowing in duct system. It is proportional to square of velocity. How? We will see by equation. Now this velocity pressure, it will increase if duct cross-sectional area decreases. So that is very easy to understand. If you decrease the area, velocity will increase. So velocity pressure will increase. If you increase the cross-sectional area of duct, okay, if duct cross-sectional area increases, the velocity pressure will decrease. Why? Because velocity decreases. Then same thing is written here in these two statements. Now when velocity pressure increases, static pressure must decrease. When velocity pressure decreases, there can be gain in static pressure. Okay, so if PV decreases, PS increases, and that is called what? Static regain. Now this static regain, it is used, this concept is used in one of the methods of duct design. Okay, we will see this later on, this method. Next is total pressure. It is denoted by P suffix T. Okay, it is change in total pressure between any two points. It is equal to sum of change in static pressure and change in velocity pressure. So if you consider static pressure plus velocity pressure, you will get total pressure. And the energy, it goes on decreasing, okay, in the direction of flow. So energy and thus the total pressure must always decrease in the direction of flow once the fan is turned on, except at the fan. Why? Because fan is at the location of the fan, there is constant pressure. The total pressure losses represents the irreversible conversion of static and kinetic energy into internal energy in the form of heat. So what will happen? Because of the pressure maintained inside the duct, there will be flow of air inside the duct. And since there is friction, if you consider the ducting system, how it will look like? Suppose this is a circular duct, we are considering circular duct. So there will be friction, then there will be change in the direction of the duct. Okay, so because of that, there will be what? Friction losses and dynamic losses. Okay, and because of these losses, okay, here you can see this energy loss, it is converted to what? Internal energy in the form of heat. Why? Because energy cannot be created or not, it can be destroyed. So the pressure losses in duct system, there are of two types. One is friction losses and second one is dynamic losses. So friction losses are produced whenever moving air flows in contact with a fixed boundary. So here we have a duct. Suppose we are considering circular duct. So air will come in contact with the surface. There will be friction and because of that we have friction losses. Next we have dynamic losses. Result of turbulence or changes in size, shape, direction or volume of flow rate of air. Because of that, whatever losses are there, those are called dynamic losses. So if you are changing the direction of duct and air is moving, the air will change its direction and because of that, there will be a loss of pressure, that is called dynamic loss. So same thing as written here, these losses are classified as either friction losses or dynamic losses. So this is meaning of friction losses and dynamic losses. Now the numerical which we are going to study, theoretical numerical, there we are going to ignore this dynamic loss, we are only going to consider friction loss. Okay, now what is Bernoulli's equation that you already know, you have studied in fluid mechanics. Total energy, it remains constant, right? So P upon rho g plus V square upon 2g plus z, it remains constant. This is modified Bernoulli's equation. What is meaning of that? P1 upon rho g plus V1 square upon 2g plus z1 equal to P2 upon rho g plus V2 square upon 2g plus z2 plus head loss. Now here basically if you consider this, here I have taken only friction, but in actual case, this term will be what? It will be delta Pt between section 1 to 2, meaning it will be both because of friction loss as well as dynamic loss. Okay, here I am neglecting the dynamic losses, that is why I have written only head lost due to friction, HLF. HLF meaning what? Head lost due to friction. Okay, but in actual case, this will be what? Delta Pt 1 to 2. It will be having both the components, friction loss as well as dynamic losses. Okay, now if you multiply this, this equation is what? In terms of head. This is pressure head, this is velocity head, and so on. If you multiply it throughout by rho g, you will get pressure. Okay, so P1 plus, you will get this equation. Now in this equation, if you consider PS1 and PV1, PS1 means static pressure of point 1, PV1 means velocity pressure of point 1. So if you add these two, you will get total pressure of point 1. Similarly, on right hand side, these two will give total pressure of 0.2 plus pressure because of losses. Okay, now here again I have written this pressure is because of loss of friction. Okay, here we are not considering the dynamic losses. Now if you want to consider the fan power, how to compute this? Okay, this we will require while solving the numerical. When a fan is introduced into the duct, through which the air is flowing, then the static and the total pressure at each section where the fan is located rises. Okay, this rise is called fan total pressure. So here we have fan total pressure and the power required by the fan. It is given by Q dot of air, that is volume flow rate of air into fan total pressure divided by efficiency of fan. Now to understand this equation, we will see some units. What is the unit of volume flow rate of air? It is meter cube per second, for example. So here we will get meter cube per second, and fan total pressure, unit of pressure is Newton per meter square. So here we have Newton per meter square. So meter square and this meter square will get cancelled. So what is the unit remaining here? Newton meter per second. What is Newton meter? Joule. Okay, so here we will get joule per second, and joule per second means what? Watt. That is power required by fan. Okay, now in actual case, this will be the fan power in theoretical case, but there will be efficiency of fan. Okay, so when you divide this value by some decimal, this value will increase. That is why here efficiency, it is there in denominator. Because efficiency, it is there in decimal. So if you are dividing this by 0.5, for example, 0.5. If you divide this equation by 0.5, the actual fan power, it will increase as compared to the ideal one. Next, we will see the chief requirements of an air conditioning duct system. Okay, so what is the major requirement of this ducting system? It should convey the specified rates of airflow to prescribed location. Meaning what? We have areas, okay, and during design stage itself, we decide what is the required flow rate of air. Okay, so that should be properly conveyed to the prescribed locations. Then it should be economical in combined initial and fan operating cost. Initial cost and fan operating cost, meaning it depends on what? Aspect ratio. If aspect ratio is maintained properly, initial cost of the material can be saved and even the fan operating cost can be saved. Then the duct work, whatever ducting system is there, it should not transmit or generate objectionable noise. Now, usually what is the procedure involved in designing? We will see that. So generally at the time of designing of air conditioning duct system, the required airflow rates are known from load calculation. So using load calculation, E20 Excel sheet or HAP software, we get flow rate of air. Then the location of fan and air outlet are fixed. So what is done by the architect, drawing is being made, like ducting systems are fixed, okay, where air terminal should be there, how the duct will run along the rooms, all the layout is done. The duct layout is then made, taking into account the space available and ease of construction. Then if you consider, in order to get the required airflow for a particular room, there could be number of ways. Okay, same thing is written here. In principle, required amount of air can be conveyed through air conditioning duct by a number of combinations. So we have number of combination, however, for a given system, one set gives the optimum design. And it is necessary to identify the relevant design parameters and then optimize the design. Now we will see what is the meaning of CFM and FPM. These two terminologies are important from interview point of view. So volume flow rate SI unit is meter cube per second and velocity SI unit is meter per second. Now if you consider IP units, volume flow rate is given by CFM and velocity it is given by FPM. We'll go through some of the units. Okay, you should know these units. 1 inch is 2.54 centimeter. And 12 inch is equal to 1 feet. So 12 into 2.54 will give us total centimeter, 30.48 centimeter, which is equal to 1 feet. and 100 centimeter is 1 meter, so we can get 1 meter is equal to 3.281 feet. So using this 1 meter equal to 3.281 feet, we can convert 1 meter cube per second into CFM. Okay, so 1 meter cube per second is equal to, so 1 meter is 3.281 feet, so 3.281 cube into 60. So we will get 2119 CFM, whereas this is related to volume flow rate. And if you consider velocity, okay, velocity 1 meter per second, to convert meter into feet, we have to multiply by 3.281. So 3.281 into 60, we will get FPM, feet per minute, which is 196.56 FPM. Next, if ducts are smaller, okay, or you can say if velocity in duct is higher, okay, anything you can say, because when if you are having, what is the equation of this one, volume flow rate? Q is equal to area into velocity. So either you can say area is small or smaller duct, or you can say velocity is large. So because of that, what will be the effect? If duct is small, or if you can say velocity is large, then duct is small. Hence, we have lower initial cost, because we are saving the material which is being used to manufacture the duct, and lower space requirement is there. But because of that, what will happen if duct area is small? There will be larger pressure drop. So pressure drop is higher, and therefore the power consumption by the fan will be large. And if you consider smaller dimension of duct, there will be increased noise. Hence, noise attenuation units are required to control the noise. Now, based on the noise, there are recommended velocities depending on different type of applications. Few applications are listed over here. For residents, 3 to 5 meter per second velocity should be maintained. Then theaters, 4 to 6.5 meter per second, and restaurants, 7.5 meter per second to 10 meter per second. Now here you can see, if you refer chapter 2 carrier handbook, you will find a table like this, which is recommended maximum duct velocity for low velocity systems. Velocity is given in FPM. Now this is, read the title of the table carefully. What is written here? Recommended maximum duct velocity, meaning this is the maximum velocity in FPM. We shouldn't go beyond this velocity, otherwise the noise will be objectionable. Okay, and this is for which type of system? Low velocity system. So we have already seen the classification of different ducting system based on velocity. Okay, so this is for low velocity system. So here you can see residence is there, then private offices is there, industrial purpose, industrial application is there. So what should be the velocity of air in the duct? That is given. So if you are considering equal friction method, we will be using, if you are going for the main duct, okay, that is the trunk part, there we will consider these velocities, okay, third column. But if you consider constant velocity method, there we will consider the second column, okay, that it is the constant velocity method, it is used for high end projects. So this you can observe here, for residents the velocity is less in second column, it is 600 FPM as compared to the third column. Okay, so second column we are going to use for constant velocity method, and the third column we are going to use for equal friction method. Now how do we design ducts? Duct sizing, it is done based on ASHRAE handbook and carrier handbook, whereas the fabrication of duct, it is based on SMACNA standards. Now we will see what are the general rules for duct design. Air should be conveyed as directly as possible to save space, power and material. So unnecessarily don't increase the size of the duct, don't increase the length of the duct. ओके सो एज डायरेक्टली एज पॉसिबल एयर शुड बी कन्वेड एट द रिक्वायर्ड लोकेशन. सडन चेंजेस इन डायरेक्शन शुड बी अवॉइडेड. दैट इज द टर्न्स ओके बेंड्स दिस शुड बी अवॉइडेड. व्हेन नॉट पॉसिबल टू अवॉइड सडन चेंजेस टर्निंग रेंज शुड बी यूज टू प्रिवेंट प्रेशर लॉस. Diverging section should be gradual. Angle of divergence is equal to 20 degree. Then aspect ratio. This point we had already discussed before. Aspect ratio should be close to 1. And normally it should not exceed 4. It is as per the guidelines by SMACNA. Okay, what is SMACNA? Sheet Metal and Air Conditioning Contractors National Association. Then air velocity should be within the permissible limit to reduce noise and vibration. If velocity is large, then noise in the duct will be large and because of that there will be discomfort. Okay. Then duct material should be as smooth as possible to reduce frictional losses. Thermal and acoustic insulation is done for the supply air duct. And VCD. What is this VCD? Volume control damper. Now to balance the pressure in the duct, volume control damper is required. And where is the location of this damper, you will be able to understand once we see the duct designing method. So volume control damper and fire and smoke dampers are provided at the required location. Now suppose there is fire in a building. Okay, so what will happen? Since duct, they run easily between the two rooms. What will happen through the duct that fire can be transmitted from one room to other room. Okay, along with that, what will go? Smoke will also go. So to prevent that, we require fire and smoke damper. Okay, so that is the importance of this fire and smoke damper. Next, we will see what are the commonly used duct design methods. Okay, now how actually this duct designing is done, the overview has been shown over here. From cooling load calculations, we get the required supply airflow rate for each conditioned space. Then based on that and from the building layout, location of supply fan and length of each duct is decided. Okay, so first we do the cooling load calculation using the architecture of the building. Okay, we know where is the room. Okay, we know what is the thickness of the wall. So with the help of the architecture, we will get the data from civil person. Okay, what is the thickness of the wall, where the window is there, in which direction. Okay, then what are the different sources of heat, that we will get. Then using that we can find the cooling load. Okay, total cooling load. Then using that we will get the supply airflow CFM. Flow rate. Then using the building layout, we can find where we should locate the supply fan, that is the air handling unit, and what should be the length of each duct run, that we can decide. Then the purpose of the duct design is to what? Select the suitable dimension for each run and then to select the fan, which can provide required supply air flow rate to each condition zone. Now the run, that is the length of the duct which is with highest pressure drop, it is called index run. And based on this index run, we decide what should be the fan power. Now following are the commonly used methods for duct design. First one is equal friction method, which is most commonly used method for residential and commercial purpose. Then second one is velocity reduction method, which is used for rough estimate. Then third one is constant velocity method, where it is used for high class projects. And last one is static regain method, it is used in industries. Okay, so we'll solve some numericals. First, we will solve numerical related to equivalent diameter of duct for rectangular duct. And after that, we will solve an example on equal friction method. then after that we will go in details of this equal friction method, because if you read the theory part directly you will not understand a single word. Okay, so we'll go to the numerical part now.